I first met in person with Mary A. in the summer of 2007. I had arranged with her husband of 15 years, Terence, to see her for an interview. Mary had intimately agreed. Since I was not a newsman, but rather an amateur writer gathering information for a few early college assignments and, if all went according to plan, some pieces of fiction, we scheduled the interview for a particular weekend when I was in Chicago on unrelated business. But at the last moment, Mary changed her mind and locked herself in the couple's bedroom, refusing to meet with me. For half an hour I sat with Terence as we camped outside the bedroom door. I listened and taking notes while he attempted fruitlessly to call his wife. The things Mary said made little sense but fit with the pattern I was expecting, though I could not see her. I could tell from her voice that she was crying, and more often than not her objections to speaking with me centered around an incoherent diatribe on her dreams, her nightmares. Terence apologized profusely when we ceased the exercise, and I did my best to take it in stride. Recall that I wasn't a reporter in search of a story, but merely a curious young man in search of information. Besides, I thought at the time, I could perhaps find another similar case if I put my mind and resources to it. Mary A. was the sizer for a small Chicago-based bulletin board system in 1992. When she first encountered Smile, and her life changed forever. She had Terence and had been married for only 5 months. Mary was one of an estimated 400 people who saw the image when it was posted as a hyperfilm on the BBS. Though she is the only one who has spoken openly about the experience, the rest have remained anonymous, or are perhaps dead. In 2005, when I was only in 10th grade, Smile was first brought to my attention by my burgeoning interest in web-based phenomena. Mary was the most often cited victim of what is sometimes referred to as Smile. The being Smile is reputed to display. What caught my interest, other than the obvious macabre elements of the cyber legend and my proclivity towards such things, was the sheer lack of information, usually to the point that people don't believe it even exists other than a rumor or a hoax. It is unique because, though the entire phenomenon centers on a picture file, that file is nowhere to be found on the internet. Certainly many photo manipulated Simurgh little the web, showing up with the most frequency on sites such as the image board 4chan, particularly the X-Focus Paranormal subboard. It is suspected these are fakes because they do not have the effect the true Smile is believed to have, namely sudden onset temporal lobe epilepsy and acute anxiety. This purported reaction in the viewer is one of the reasons the phantoms like Smile is regarded with such disdain, since it is painfully absurd. Though depending on whom you ask, the reluctance to acknowledge Smile existence might be just as much out of fear as it is out of disbelief. Neither Smile nor Smile Dog is mentioned anywhere on Wikipedia, though the website features articles on such other, perhaps more scandalous, shock sites as Hello or Two Girls One Cup, any attempt to create a page pertaining to Smile is summarily deleted by any of the Encyclopedia's many admins. Encounters with Smile are the stuff of internet legend. Mary A's story is not unique. There are unverified rumors of Smile showing up in the early days of Asenet and even on persistent tale that in 2002 a hacker floated the forms of humor and said our website something awful with a deluge of Smile dog pictures, rendering almost half the forum's users at the time epileptic.